And the program starts on YouTube Live.
यूट्यूब पे आ रहा है ना, शुरू हो गया।
ध्वनि स्पष्ट रूपेण आयाति किम्?
श्रूयते।
अस्माकं विभागाध्यक्ष महोदयः अपि विराजमानः सन्ति।
गुरुवर समागता किम्?
नमस्कार।
आपके साथ मैडम का डील होता है तो आप भेजना और जो भी कुछ है मतलब गोविंद जी, काफी समस्या जाता हुआ।
हाँ वो अस्माकं ये च वक्तार सन्ति प्रोफेसर सत्यनारायण
आम
सः पूर्वं तत्र मोबाइल मध्ये उद्घाटितवान् अनन्तरं त लैपटॉप मध्ये प्रयत्नं कृतवान्
अच्छा
लैपटॉप मध्ये काचन समस्या आगता
मोबाइल माध्यमेन एव करणीय
हाँ मोबाइल माध्यमेन तदेव उक्तवान् अहम्
आम्
निमेष एकद्वयं वा तत्र अपेक्षते
अच्छा
Sir, yes, sir. Is there any problem, sir? Mm-hmm. सर यू हैव टू जस्ट क्लिक ऑन दैट लिंक दैट यूआरएल लिंक हाँ सेंड सेंड ऑन द वेब व्हाट्सएप यस सर
हेलो
इदानीं
स्वागतं महोदयानां नो आई कैन सी नाउ आई कैन सी स्टार्ट वीडियो स्टार्ट माय वीडियो हेलो नाउ आई सी
अस्माकं मुख्य वक्ता रहा
प्रोफेसर सत्यन
चक्रवर्ती महाभागः विराजमाना संति प्रणमौमि
हेलो
Am I audible to all of you? इदानीं मन्ये आरम्भः करणीयः सत्रस्य अस्य अद्य वयं
श्रूयते किं
स्मः संस्कृतसप्ताह समारोहे अत्र अद्य प्रथमं दिनं विद्यते तत्र आदौ यदा अस्माकं परम्परा विद्यते मङ्गलादीनि मङ्गलमध्यानि मङ्गलान्तानि च शास्त्राणि तदेव परम्पराम् अनुसृत्य आदौ वैदिकं मङ्गलाचरणं हरेः ॐ भद्रं कर्णेभिः शृणुयां मा देवा भद्रं पश्येमाक्षाभिर्जत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैः दुष्टो वा पुंसस्तनु दिव्यशेमहि देवहि तञ्जदायुः हरिः ॐ इदानीम् अस्माकं विभागस्य छात्रा अन्वेषा तमोली एकं गीतं प्रस्तौति अन्वेषा तमोली
नमो नमः नमो नमः संस्कृतस्य रक्षणाय बद्धपरिकरा वयं संस्कृते प्रवर्धनाय गृहनिधिर्भवेदिदम् संस्कृतस्य रक्षणाय बद्धपरिकरा वयं संस्कृते प्रवर्धनाय गृहनिधिर्भवेदिदम् संस्कृतस्य महिमा वर्णनेन नास्ति साधितम् सतत सम्भाषणेन तस्य जीवनं स्थिरम् संस्कृतस्य महिमा वर्णनेन नास्ति साधितम् सतत सम्भाषणेन तस्य जीवनं स्थिरम् जनमुखेन भाषितं ननु जगति जीवितम् राजते चिरं समस्तराष्ट्रमान्यतास्पदम् राजते चिरं समस्तराष्ट्रमान्यतास्पदम् संस्कृतस्य रक्षणाय बद्धपरिकरा वयम् संस्कृते प्रवर्धनाय गृहनिधिर्भवेदिदम् संस्कृतस्य सेवनं मातृसेवा समम् संस्कृतस्य सेवनं मातृसेवा समम् तेन संभाषणं वाङ्मातृपूजनम् मातृभिः प्रवर्तनेन मातृभाषा परम् सरल संभाषणेन लसति वालारितम् संस्कृतस्य रक्षणाय बद्धपरिकरा वयम् संस्कृते प्रवर्धनाय गृहनिधिर्भवेदिदम् राजशोषणात् पुरा नीतमिदं वैभवम् लोकशक्तिकेन्द्रितं स्थास्यतिह केवलम् शिक्षकास्तदर्थमेव त्यागशालिनः संस्कृत उज्जीवनाय प्राप्त जीवना ध्रुवम् संस्कृत उज्जीवनाय प्राप्त जीवनां ध्रुवम् संस्कृतस्य रक्षणाय बद्धपरिकरा वयम् संस्कृते प्रवर्धनाय गृहनिधिर्भवेदिदम् संस्कृते प्रवर्धनाय गृहनिधिर्भवेदिदम् संस्कृते प्रवर्धनाय गृहनिधिर्भवेदिदम् धन्यवाद
धन्यवादः अन्वेष मान्याः संस्कृतसप्ताह समारोहे तत्र संस्कृतविभागेन असम विश्वविद्यालयस्य संस्कृतविभागेन संस्कृतसप्ताहसमारोहस्य आयोजनम् अस्माभिः क्रियते समारोहेऽस्मिन् अस्माभिः परिकल्पिताः यद् एका राष्ट्रियव्याख्यानमाला भवेत् तत्र षड् वक्तारः सन्ति आदौ अद्य प्रोफेसर् सत्यनारायण चक्रवर्ती महाभागः विद्यन्ते तस्य विषयः संस्कृतम् अतीते वर्तमाने भविष्यति च अनन्तरं श्वः प्रोफेसर् नवरत्नम् सेनापति महोदयः भविष्यन्ति भारतीय आर्यभाषाणां शुद्धतायां संस्कृतव्याकरणविषये काचित् समीक्षा इति विषये उपरि तस्य व्याख्यानं भविष्यति प्रोफेसर् श्रीनिवासराय महाभागः विद्यते असमराज्ये संस्कृताध्ययनस्य स्थितिः बाराकोपत्यकायाः विशेषसन्दर्भे इति तेषां विषयः भविष्यन्ति प्रोफेसर् सत्यपाल सिंह चौहान महाभागः साहित्यं सौन्दर्यशास्त्रञ्च इति विषयोपरि प्रोफेसर् भगीरथी विश्वास महाभागः संस्कृतस्य महत्त्वं प्रासङ्गिकता च एवं च डाक्टर् कर्तारचन्द्रशर्मा महाभागः काव्यशास्त्रस्य विकासे काश्मीर संस्कृतलेखनावदानम् इति विषयोपरि तत्र तस्य व्याख्यानं भविष्यति अपि च अस्माभिः समारोहेऽस्मिन् तत्र छात्राणां कृते शोधछात्राणां कृते अपि तत्र काचित् प्रतियोगिता निर्धारिताः तासु प्रतियोगितासु प्रश्नमञ्चप्रतियोगिता विद्यते संस्कृतलेखनप्रतियोगिता विद्यते स्वरचित संस्कृतलघुकथा लेखनप्रतियोगिता विद्यते एकाङ्कीय नाटकलेखनप्रतियोगिता विद्यते चित्रनिर्माणप्रतियोगिता च अस्माभिः परिकल्पिता अस्मिन् संस्कृतसप्ताहसमारोहे अस्यैव तत्र कार्यक्रमे अद्य अस्माकं तत्र ऋषितुल्यः अस्माकं प्रथमवक्तारः सन्ति प्रोफेसर् सत्यनारायण चक्रवर्ती महाभागः तेषां स्वागतवचनार्थम् अपि च संस्कृतदिवसस्योपालन विषये तत्र उद्देश्य वचनार्थम् अहम् अस्माकं विभागाध्यक्षं प्रति प्रोफेसर् शान्ति पोखरेल् महाभागं प्रति अनुरुन्धे यद् आगत्य अस्माकं वक्तु यद्यपि तस्य परिचयस्य कापि आवश्यकता नास्ति यतो हि तेषां परिचयः एतादृश दीर्घः अस्ति ये सर्वे जानन्ति एव तथापि औपचारिक रूपेण तेषां परिचयः कार्यः इति अनिरुन्धे अस्माकं विभागाध्यक्षं प्रति
सर्वेभ्यः गुरुजनेभ्यः नमो नमः अत्र उपस्थितेभ्यः अद्यतनीय कार्यक्रमस्य प्रमुखवक्तृभ्यः आचार्य सत्यनारायण चक्रवर्ती महाभागेभ्यः असम विश्वविद्यालय पक्षतः संस्कृत विभाग पक्षतश्च सप्रणामं सादरं स्वागतं व्याहरामि विभागेन आयोजितेषु सप्ताहव्यापी कार्यक्रमेषु व्याख्यान प्रदानार्थं आमंत्रितान् सर्वान् गुरुजनान् मदीय विभागस्य आचार्याः आचार्यान् असम विश्वविद्यालयस्य अन्य विश्वविद्यालयानां महाविद्यालयानां शिक्षण संस्थानां च अध्यापकान् अध्यापिकाश्च संस्कृत भारत्याः कार्यकर्तृन् कार्यक्रमेस्मिन् अंशग्राहिणः शोधच्छात्रान् विद्यार्थिनश्च संस्कृत विभाग पक्षतः असम विश्वविद्यालय पक्षतश्च हार्दिकं स्वागतं व्याहरामि वयं सर्वे जानीमः यत् 1969 इति आङ्ग्लाब्दतः अर्थात् राखी संस्कृतत्वे आचर्यते केन्द्र सर्वकारेण सूचितं यत् श्रावण संस्कृत प्रारभ्य सप्ताह आचरण परंपरा प्रारब्ध असम विश्वविद्यालयस्य संस्कृत विभागेनापि प्रतिवर्षं संस्कृत सप्ताह आयोज्यते अस्मिन् वर्षे कोरोना महामारी कारणात् सर्वाणि शैक्षणिक कार्याणि ऑनलाइन माध्यमेन प्रचलितानि इह यथा असौविध्यं वर्तते तथैव सौविध्यम् अपि विलसति देश विदेशस्य विद्वांसः स्वगृहतः एव समग्रे पारगाः निमग्नाः उपलब्धाः च सन्ति एतत् सौविध्यम् अस्माभिरपि सौविध्यम् इदम् आश्रित्य कोलकातातः काश्मीरपर्यन्तानां विदुषां भार्चुअल् सान्निध्यं प्राप्तम् अद्य अस्माकम् आमन्त्रणं स्वीकृत्य राष्ट्रियव्याख्यानमालायाः प्रारम्भं करिष्यन्ति कोलकातास्थ रवीन्द्रभारती विश्वविद्यालयस्य अवसरप्राप्ताः आचार्याः प्रोफेसर सत्यनारायण चक्रवर्ती महाभागः व्याख्यानस्य विषयो अस्ति संस्कृत स्टडीज प्रेजेंट पास्ट एंड फ्यूचर मया इह महोदयानां संक्षिप्तः परिचयः उपस्थाप्यते अत्र भवन्तः आचार्याः सत्यनारायण चक्रवर्ती महाभागा कोलकातास्थ रवींद्र भारती विश्वविद्यालयतः अवसर प्राप्ताः येषां विजिटिंग प्रोफेसर रूपेण देश विदेशेषु विश्रुतिर् विद्य अत्र भवद्भिः फ्रांस देश पेरिस नगरस्थे सर्वन्ने नोवेल्ले विश्वविद्यालये विजिटिंग प्रोफेसर रूपेण कार्यं संपादितवान् भारतवर्षस्य बहुषु विश्वविद्यालयेषु अत्र भवन्तः विजिटिंग प्रोफेसर रूपेण आसन् येषु सेंटर फॉर एडवांस इन संस्कृत पुणे गुवाहाटी विश्वविद्यालयः त्रिपुरा विश्वविद्यालयः जगन्नाथ संस्कृत विश्वविद्यालयः प्रमुखाः विदेशेषु अपि विशेषतः अमेरिका कनाडा इंग्लैंड स्कॉटलैंड इटली जर्मनी फिनलैंड नेदरलैंड बेल्जियम ग्रीस सोवियत रशिया, हंगेरी, दक्षिण अफ्रीका, बांग्लादेश, थाईलैंड, चाइना, हांगकांग, जापान, सिंगापुर, न्यूजीलैंड, ऑस्ट्रेलिया, इंडोनेशिया, भूटान इत्यादि देशस्थानां विश्वविद्यालयानां ज्ञानपिपासवः अत्र भवतां पांडित्य प्रवचनैः ऋद्धः जातः। अस्माकम् आमन्त्रणं स्वीकृत्य असम विश्वविद्यालये संस्कृत विभागे च चक्रवर्ती महाभागानां यदा यदा आगमनं जातं, वयं च तदा तदा सारस्वतरसैः सिञ्चिताः उपकृताः। अत्र भवद्भिः पञ्चविंशत्यधिकग्रन्थाः विरचिताः, येषु ये स्टडी आफ् चित्रमीमांसा आफ् अप्पय्यदीक्षित, धर्मशास्त्रे आत्महत्या, इकोलॉजी एंड अदर एसेज, प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ ट्रांसलिटरेशन, कालिदास एवं अन्यान्य निबंध, त्रयी, मेघदूत और सौदामिनी, चाणक्य नीति शास्त्र समीक्षा, पाणिनीय शब्दशास्त्र, धन्यालोक तत्र एक अनुदित ग्रंथ से एकै आकाश एकै धरा, शांति शतकश्च प्रमुखः। अत्र अधुनापि नाना शैक्षणिक संस्थाभिः सह संयुक्ताः सन्तः स्वकीय सारस्वत साधने प्रतिनः सन्ति। महोदय, अहम् पुनरपि असम विश्वविद्यालय पक्षतः, असम विश्वविद्यालयस्य संस्कृत विभाग पक्षतश्च आन्तरिकं स्वागतं प्रणामं च विनिवेदयामि। इयं नेशनल लेक्चर सीरीज अर्थात राष्ट्रीय व्याख्यानमाला इत्यस्य कार्यक्रमस्य समन्वयकः कोऑर्डिनेटर विभागस्य युवा उत्साही उद्योगी अध्यापकः डॉक्टर गोविंद शर्मणः विशेष प्रयासेन आयोजिता, तस्मै च साधुवादं प्रचार्य अहं विरमामि। नमो नमः।
धन्यवादः महोदयः। आई वांट टू टेल यू दैट मोर देन 900 पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैव बीन रजिस्टर्ड फॉर दिस नेशनल लेक्चर सीरीज एंड मोर देन 150 पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैव बीन रजिस्टर्ड फॉर कॉम्पिटिशन्स इन वेरियस कॉम्पिटिशन्स ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ संस्कृत। इदानीं अस्माकं विभागीयाः वरिष्ठ आचार्याः प्रोफेसर स्निग्धादास राय महाभागं प्रति अनुरुन्धे यद् कार्यक्रमविषये समारोहविषये किञ्चित् वचनार्थम्।
From 31st July to 6th of August, who the Department of Sanskrit is going to organize different programs, academic and non-academic, to celebrate Sanskrit Week. In this celebration process, the department is very much fortunate that scholars from many other universities are giving their blessings, giving their academic blessings, and thereby glorifying the Department of Sanskrit. This July, the month of July is very much important, particularly, am I audible?
Yes, madam, you are audible.
Okay, so this July, particularly 2020, is very memorable, important for the Department of Sanskrit. in this 2020, we have completed 25 years of our the departments started in the year 1995 and in the month of July. And as this is the 25th year, earlier we planned to organize on our part to celebrate this completion of 25 years, but for the global worsened situation have made us a little bit perplexed that whether we will be able to celebrate this year our completion of 25 years, because all are the locked down situation. But we believe in the principle of the show, and it is the enthusiastic entrepreneurship of our department. I particularly mentioned Dr. Govind Sharma, who is our asset, who is our pride, and his initiative, we could have organized a week-long program. I think a very brilliant week-long program, and I hope, I pray to Almighty that the program be a success. The department started with 4 teachers. I would like to remember, I would like to recall their names here. Professor Kali Prasanna Sinha, Professor Swapna Devi, who was on the steering in building up the department, Professor Horipada Chakraborty, and myself joined the department in the month of July 1995. We started the journey on 1995 July, and during the down the lanes of 25 years, all of the members started the beginning in a brilliant way, and these have been joined by Professor Bhagirathi Vishwas, Professor Shanti Pokhrel, and lastly, our dear boy, Govind Sharma. The department is now going with 4 full pleasant staff and 2 guest lecturers. Those are also our Dr. Sriman Tapan Kumar Shil, Dr. Sanu Sita. Those 2 are also assets to our department. What are our achievements? We won't say anything. We left it to you all, sir. But one thing we can say, that our sincerity, our continuous endeavor in building up the department is on with our fullest sincerity, with our fullest dedication. And right now the department is having a very good number of research scholars in the stream of PhD, in the stream of MPhil, and many in both the semesters. We are confined to our department. The department is contributing to the out of the university also, we have been organizing Sanskrit speaking course, then many other programs outside also. The department is credited with organizing many seminars and regular lectures from different scholars, and thereby it is being enriched. At today, our Paramacharya, our philosopher, our guide for quite a long years, Hartman, my teacher like, we are very much, their department is proficiently, we are getting his advice, we are getting enriched his guidances, and we are fortunate enough. I am feeling very much proud here. I am feeling myself privileged here at the Ceylon with the department, on behalf of the department, that today our national lecture series will start with Professor Satya Narayan Chakraborty, and we are eagerly waiting for listen to his lecture. I also extend my heartfelt eagerness to listen to the other speakers also, Professor Narottam, Professor Satyapal Singh Chauhan, Professor Kartar Chandra Sharma, in this week long lecture series. Today, let it be a auspicious beginning. Let it be the week be successful. Let my scholars, let my students, let my faculties, my fellow faculties, all are enriched with this lecture series. Let us be benefited. Let us see a new direction to the study of Sanskrit. I pray to Almighty, let this journey of ours, this journey of the Department of Sanskrit, let it continue in a healthy way, and in an enriched way. Sarvebhyo punarapi namo namah. Jayatu Sanskritam, jayatu Bharat. Namo namah.
Thank you, ma'am, for your great inspiration and blessing for always blessings for our department, always cooperation for our department. Idanim samaya asti yasya krite vayam sarve bahu pratikshitaha panditya purnam bhashana shrotum mahodayoyam vyakaran shastre साहित्यशास्त्रे मीमांसाशास्त्रे वेदान्तशास्त्रे च कृत भूरि परिश्रमाः बहु प्रखर वक्तारः अस्माकं प्रोफेसर सत्यनारायण चक्रवर्ती महाभागः तां प्रति अनुरोधः अस्ति यद् अद्यतन विषय उपरि स्वकीय भाषणं कर्तुं महोदयः
Should I start?
Please.
Hello.
Hello. Ah, yes, please, sir.
Should I start?
Ah, yes, yes, sir.
Yeah, all right. Thank you. या कुंदेन्दु तुषार हार धवला या श्वेत पद्मासना या वीणा वरदंड मंडित करा या शुभ्र वस्त्रावृता ब्रह्मच्युत शंकर प्रभृति देवै सदा वंदिता आ मां पातु सरस्वती भगवती निःशेष जड्यापहा। अद्य शीलचरस्थ आसाम विश्वविद्यालय समायोजिते संस्कृत दिवसोत्सवे आमंत्रितोऽहम् आत्मानं कृतार्थं मन्ये, किञ्च आमंत्रण प्रदानार्थं संस्कृत विभागीय अध्यापकेभ्यः भूयो भूय धन्यवादाश्च निवेद्यते। संस्कृत विभागीय छात्राः सर्वे जानन्ति एव संस्कृतस्य माहात्म्यम्, जानन्ति च संस्कृत अध्ययनस्य अवस्थां यत्किञ्चित् सौविध्यम् असौविध्यम् वा, तेषां कृते मदीयं भाषणं नापेक्षते। मदीयं वक्तव्यं क्षुद्रे परिमण्डले यथा आबद्धं न स्यात्, यथा शिक्षा व्यवस्थायां समासीनः आधिकारिकः च भारतीयः किमिदानीं करणीयम् इति जानीयुः, तदर्थं मया आङ्ग्लभाषया यत्किञ्चित् निवेद्यते। विषयः खलु संस्कृतम् अतीते वर्तमाने भविष्यति च। Sanskrit, biggest repository of Indian priceless heritage, a statement that no one can dare to deny. It had enough inherent strength in successfully tackling with repeated social convulsions, religious reforms and foreign invasions, and lived continuously for thousands of years, and at the same time remain as the main life force of the whole subcontinent without a break. There is hardly any comparison to this wonderful achievement in the whole world. The Indian people and Indian civilization were born, so to say, in the lap of Sanskrit, and it went hand in hand with the historical development of the culture as well. In this regard, we may refer to the landmark judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court of India in 1993 on Sanskrit studies in India. So far, the people of India are concerned, is held in high esteem the cultural heritage of this ancient land, and portal or learning of Sanskrit is undoubtedly necessary for protection of this heritage. The stream of our culture would get dried if we were to discourage the study of Sanskrit, the judgment exactly represents the sentiment of Indian mind. Sanskrit had the highest pedestal as its seat in past, still continues to possess the same position at present, and hopefully will continue to occupy in future. There were hundreds of great centers of Sanskrit studies, some with advanced courses of special branches of Shastras. India commanded great respect from foreigners because of these institutions. In this regard, a few facts of recent past must come to mind of people, particularly those who had suffered due to partition taken place on political ground, simply political ground, and fled from their motherland for the sake of life. From East Pakistan, now Bangladesh, it had been populated by a large number of Hindu people, many of whom were Brahmins, and almost of them were Sanskrit scholars. There were thousands of tolls or chatushpatis of Sanskrit studies, so much so that in some villages there were more than 10 in number. In almost all such institutions, students were given free education, free boarding, free lodging. In spite of the fact that the Pandits were actually financially poor, they were rich in mentality, had a little less money, but had great honor. They had been taking it as a social responsibility and an act of punya, a pious duty. Hardly any family was without a tirtha holder like Kabba Tirtha, Vyakarana Tirtha, Smriti Tirtha, Sankha Tirtha, or other degrees like Sahitya Vinod, Tarka Chudamani, etc. It is a fact that there are more than 10 Mahamahupadhyayas from one single district itself. Each told at thousands of owned hereditary and prepared by themselves as well. On the strength of my practical knowledge, it may be mentioned that following the system of using regional scripts, in every part of India, all those manuscripts were Bengali script. All those manuscripts were lost at the time of riot, just put to fire. In fact, the house was looted first, and then the huge number of manuscripts were used as fuel to fire the whole house. Empty-handed, the Pandits migrated to West Bengal, treated as refugees, Udvastu, and lived on government dole. So, the chain of Sanskrit studies and creation of Sanskrit scholars was disrupted greatly, particularly in this part of India. It was not possible to revive earlier position due to massive change in social structure. A discussion on the future of Sanskrit needs a survey of the present position of the language in education system and its impact on the culture as a whole. For years, about four decades, the position of Sanskrit in Indian education system is a history of declining popularity and importance. It was not unknown to or unnoticed by the government. The Indian education policy makers repeatedly mentioned, considering the special importance of Sanskrit to the growth and development of Indian language and its unique contribution to the cultural unity of the country, facilities for its teaching at the school and university stages should be offered on more liberal basis. Development of new methods of teaching the language should be encouraged, and the possibility explored of including the study of Sanskrit in those courses like ancient Indian history and culture, sociology, Indian philosophy, etc., at the first and second degree stages, where such knowledge is useful. Research in Indology, the humanities, and social sciences should receive adequate support. To fulfill the need for the synthesis of knowledge, interdisciplinary research should be encouraged. Efforts should be made to delve into India's ancient fund of knowledge and to relate it to contemporary reality. Many more concrete suggestions were given so that we may utilize India's ancient stock of knowledge. But sometimes even good suggestions do not yield good results. And unfortunately, it happened so in this regard. Due to not having proper synchronization between theory and practice, goodwill and actual demand of the mass, sometimes mere projection of glorious without arousing interest in the subject itself. We are aware of the fact that the Vedas, the Vedangas, store of all knowledge, the Upanishads, preaching for immortality, and know the whole world as one nest. The Ramayana and the Mahabharata, the only epics in its true sense. The Puranas, storehouse of contemporary history, geography, torchbearers of awareness for maintaining balance and reflection of the whole society with all its rites and customs. The Smriti Shastra and Artha Shastra, having all details of social rules, law and justice, and whole social structure of the time. Literature in prose, poetry, mixed form and drama, food for aesthetic pleasure. Both strong. Poetics and dramaturgy, having analysis of the application and the process of aesthetic realization as the knowledge of language and grammar that constitutes the whole world of communication. Technology and craft, policy and governance, ethics, architecture, astrology, astronomy, mathematics, agriculture, trade and commerce, medicine, life science, and many other branches of science. To say concisely, all that makes humanity in totality had been written in Sanskrit. On the strength of my association with college and university levels, particularly with admission boards everywhere, I have noticed that in practice, people in general were not, in the recent past, most likely in present days as well, are not much interested to see that their sons and daughters opt for Sanskrit studies in college or university levels. If they are eligible for other streams like science and technology, commerce, subjects like economics, English, or even social sciences. For 15 to 20 years, during 70s and 80s, option for Sanskrit was, in Bengali, what is called agati-rigati. Entry, because without having any entry to other streams. And Sanskrit departments were compared with Sikh industry. The cutoff marks for admission had to be lowered so that the department is not abolished. A few exceptions are there, no doubt, but the number is never encouraging. Let us not play hide and seek game and accuse government, whether state or central, as the only reason behind it, and remain silent on the fact that academic circles also fail to create public awareness. Even Sanskrit loving people or people living on Sanskrit themselves were not faithfully believing in possible bright future in continuing Sanskrit studies, so to say, not practicing what they preach. Mere demonstrations, processions, and demands can hardly compel a government to change its policy. However, a silver line is this: the present government is trying to see that Sanskrit is given an important role in the education system. The question, however, remains as to how much interest it may create amongst the mass. Anyway, let us start with the mention of institutions, big or small, active or not so active, which are associated with teaching, research, or preservation of Sanskrit language, or promotion of Indian culture, and say a few words on the future prospect and role of those agencies side by side. Sanskrit is hardly a compulsory subject all through the school level. Number of students actually opting for Sanskrit as optional subject is poor. A comparative statistical analysis of the number of students appearing for final examination, or even the number of examiners, to make it easy, will show the exact picture. In humanities stream, also in upper classes, it is not a compulsory subject. What to say with regard to other streams? In college level as well, its status remains the same. In a few states, some attempts are noticed to give more importance to this language in academic institutions, but the picture is not bright in all India level. It is not a spoken language in any state. In such a situation, scope of Sanskrit studies must be limited. Now I come to some details of Sanskrit promoting institutions, which are mentioned in several categories. A. Schools. Generally, in some states, in school syllabus, Sanskrit is an optional subject in class 7 and 8 levels. And then in 9 and 10, it is an additional subject with many subjects like mathematics, statistics, etc. So far as the number of students is concerned, the picture is not good at all. But it must be admitted that there is at least a little scope of knowing the language at the ground level. In some states, however, emphasis is given on study of Sanskrit, and many schools run by private bodies, Sanskrit stotras are recited regularly and that helps creating a respect for Sanskrit. But mere respect will not work. If we sincerely try to increase number of students at school level, the only way to be suggested is to make Sanskrit compulsory with continuity. I repeat, compulsory with continuity till school leaving level. B, colleges. In many colleges, if not purely a commerce or science college, Sanskrit is one of the subjects. Unfortunately, in many institutions, it is only a past subject, not having honors, and thus creating a problem in continuing higher master's course in the subject. Universities. See, in almost all the universities, Sanskrit is a full department, even though the number of students may be less. The department publishes yearly journal in or on Sanskrit. Teachers themselves are associated with research works and supervising students for MPhil, PhD research. Professors of Sanskrit have greatest role in the field of philology, and most of them have contributed a lot making people aware of the hidden treasure preserved in Sanskrit works. University of Calcutta, Rabindra Bharati University, Kolkata, Jadavpur University, Bardwan University, Vishwabharati, Shantiniketan, Kalyani University, Sidhu Kanu University, West Bengal State University at Barasat, and many more universities which were established recently, very recently, in last 7 or 8 years. Gujarat University, Saurashtra University, MS University, Vadodara, Delhi University, Utkal University, Guwahati University, Aligarh University, Rajasthan University, Karnataka University, Kumar Bhaskar Verma University of Sanskrit and Ancient Studies at Nalwadi in Assam, Assam University at Silchar, Tripura University, Sagar University, Bikram University, Bombay University, Pune University, Madras University, Kerala University, Andhra University, Osmania University, Patna University, Himachal University, Benaras Hindu University, Allahabad University, Kurukshetra University, Jammu University, and many others. The list is never exhaustive, as you may understand. A trying hard for promotion of Sanskrit. These institutions not only run PG courses in Sanskrit with a number of specialization, but publish Sanskrit journals, organize seminars, workshops, debate competitions, extempo speech in Sanskrit, etc. D. Trolls and Gurukuls. Chatushpat. The traditional system of Chatushpatis are still continuing. In some states, very forcefully, and of course, very weakly in others. The syllabus, the medium of instruction, and the language as well are prepared in Sanskrit. Degrees like Shastri, Acharya, Tirtha are offered, and successful candidates are very often absorbed in those institutions or Sanskrit colleges and universities. However, more government help is needed so that teachers do not remain ill-paid and traditional pundits with good quality may not hesitate joining in such institutions. Moreover, students joining these courses are taking it for an additional degree of getting a post of a school teacher in a regular school. Availability of job in future is always a great factor for selection of a subject of study. E. Selected colleges and universities. These may be termed as modern version of tolls and chatushpatis. There are a number of such colleges and universities in almost all states. Degrees in UG, PG, PhD, Vidya Bharati, D.Litt, Vidya Vachaspati, Shastra Chudamani in various branches of Sanskrit studies like Veda, Mimamsa, Nyaya, Vedanta, Sankhya, Kavya, Alankara, Astrology, Ayurveda, are offered. Institutions in Tirupati, Delhi, Lal Bahadur Shastri and others, Puri Jagannath, Darbhanga, Kameshwar Singh University, Haridwar, Gurukul Kangadi, Varanasi, Sampurnanandu and many others, and other places are doing very well for the promotion of Sanskrit. Lessons in all the subjects relating to science, mathematics, geography and the like are given fully in Sanskrit. Students feel free speaking in Sanskrit. Teachers are well paid and they are actively contributing to Sanskrit studies. Creation of more and more such institutions will help creation of new job opportunities as well in future. It is very good that henceforth Sanskrit deemed universities would be central universities. Ministry of HRD, now it will F. Rashtriya Sanskrit Sansthan, Ministry of Human Research and Development, Government of India, to promote, propagate and preserve the traditional Sanskrit learning. Research work is carried out by scholars. The institution works as a central governing office of various centers of Sanskrit learning. Next is institutions trying to make Sanskrit popular by various means. In this category, let us mention a few like Delhi Sanskrit Academy, Uttar Pradesh Sanskrit Academy, Kalidas Academy, Ujjain, Sanskrit Bharati, Delhi, Gujarat Sanskrit Academy, and many institutions like this organize various programs, Mahotsavas, seminars and cultural performances, which are very hopeful for popularizing Sanskrit studies and promotion of research in Indology. Kalidas Academy in particular in Ujjain has been contributing a lot in this regard. Institutions organizing classes for spoken Sanskrit. Lokobhasha Prachar Samiti, Sanskrit Bharati, and other institutions and some other local organizations promoting Indian culture are organizing spoken Sanskrit classes of 7 days, 10 days, sometimes of even of longer duration, generally for college and university students.
it is producing good result. However, it would produce more impact if more and more students of at school level come under such programs. Institutions promoting creative writing in Sanskrit. Institutions like Sahitya Academy, Delhi Sanskrit Academy, and other state Sanskrit academies announce cash prizes and awards for creative writing in Sanskrit. Prose, poetry, novel, essay, etc. And also offer financial help towards publication of thesis in or on Sanskrit every year. In the field of literature, Gyanapith Award also has been awarded to some Sanskrit poets. Next is Government Awards for Sanskrit Teachers. Government of India honors Sanskrit teachers of repute. Certificate of Honor from the President of India, Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan, etc. are awarded regularly. Such honors from the highest office of the government have a great role for promotion of Sanskrit. Many institutions run by the government but enjoying autonomy are also doing a lot for promotion of Sanskrit. Next, I come to religious institutions like temples and mosques for promotion of Sanskrit. In ancient days, at least for a certain period, Sanskrit was the medium of higher education, and books of all branches of knowledge were composed in that language. Still today, sometimes it is looked upon as a language for Hindu religion. The reason behind this idea is easily understood. Almost all the religious institutions do work for promotion of Sanskrit. Publications of works on religion in Sanskrit original or translations in local languages. There are hundreds of schools and colleges, even universities, which are run by such religious institutions. Tirupati Devasthanam, Ramakrishna Mission, Gaudiya Vaishnav Mission, ISKCON, Shankar Math, Sri Sitaram Das Vidyalay, Nimbarko Math, Sri Chaitanya Math, Sri Venkateshwara Institute, Asha Bhai Trust, hundreds of Vedic schools, and many others, and publication units of almost all these temples, small or big, are helping preserve Sanskrit culture and religion through publication of works of all mantra, stotra, shastra composed in Sanskrit, Sanskrit translations are very helpful of this language. Next, to institutional and personal attempts through publication of Sanskrit journals. There are some people who work for promotion of Sanskrit with no exception of financial assistance from government or any society. They spend a lot of money for publication of Sanskrit journals, weekly or monthly, news magazines, books which are distributed free of cost. Selfless service for promotion of Sanskrit are examples to the whole nation. They take it as a pious duty. Sometimes they do not even disclose their name. As earlier, almost all the universities having the Department of Sanskrit publish annual journals, and rising scholars of Sanskrit get a chance to publish their results. Some colleges publish world magazines in Sanskrit regularly. Next is research institutes. let us mention a few prominent institutions in this category. Vandarkar Oriental Research Institute, Pune, Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Mumbai, Asiatic Society, Kolkata, Mumbai, Oriental Research, Madras, Center for Advanced Studies in Sanskrit, Pune, Indira Gandhi Center for Arts, Delhi, Varanasi, Deccan College, Pune, Visheshwarananda Vedic Research Institute, Punjab, K.P. Jaiswal Institute, Patna, Ramakrishna Mission Institute of Culture, Kolkata, Academy of Sanskrit Research, Melkote, Chinmoy International, and others are doing wonderful research in Sanskrit. Next is Indian Council for Cultural Relations, better known as ICCR. There are some posts of Sanskrit professors, mostly for a short period, and a few for full 2 or 3 years in foreign countries, which come under some bilateral MOU, Memorandum of Understanding. The above list classified in several categories, though not exhaustive, present an overall idea of the institutions which are working for promotion, development, preservation of Indic studies in general and Sanskrit studies in particular. Outside India, there is some sort of scope for Sanskrit studies outside India in countries like France, Germany, Bangladesh, Thailand, Italy, Belgium, Indonesia, Canada, Hungary, and others. The present author has personal experience from his visits as a visiting professor to many countries. In fact, in most cases, Sanskrit centers are established for researchers who may be interested to know about Indian history, philosophy, and religion in particular, medical science, and some other branches of science. One may not hope that number of such institutions are many and number of students is large. On the contrary, it is limited to a very small circle. Earlier, even in 1980s or 1990s, there were full Sanskrit departments in some foreign universities, which are now converted to the Department of Asian Studies or Southeast Asian Studies. So, purely Sanskrit department hardly exists. Number of regular full posts of professors of Sanskrit are decreasing. And if number of students fall, the post itself is abolished. It must be admitted that there are great Sanskrit scholars in these countries who have and still doing a lot of research, translating Sanskrit works and contributing for Indic studies through various projects. Their love for Sanskrit and sincerity to work cannot be questioned. It is some type of personal effort supported financially by the university and the government. In countries like Bangladesh, there are departments of Sanskrit in many universities, like Dhaka University, Chattogram University, Rajshahi University, etc. This is students who belong to science teams but could not get a berth at postgraduate studies opted for Masters of Sanskrit and continued PhD studies as well and are absorbed in college and university education system without much background of the basic knowledge of language. However, teachers try hard to overcome the problem and some have successfully come out. Anyway, posts, maybe small in number, are filled up and there are students. A fact that is good for Sanskrit. In Thailand, there are some good institutions which promote Sanskrit and it appears that government of that country is really interested to see that this language is properly studied for a better understanding of culture and heritage of the people. In other countries like China, Japan also, the picture is almost the same. Translations, annotated texts, mostly of Indian religion and philosophy, are coming up regularly. But as said earlier, all these are happening out of love for research of a few people only. Now that research on Sanskrit as a computer-friendly language, scope of its being helpful in artificial language, AI, astro-medical sciences in Sanskrit work, use of Ayurveda system of medicine to avoid side effects of allopathy, practical application of yoga in stress management, ecological implication of the Vedas, Upanishads, Puranas, and scientific analysis of all the theories as in Sanskrit texts spreading over all the branches of science is going on with much enthusiasm. We may expect more and more in-depth study of Sanskrit. Future of Sanskrit depends on these institutions. And if there is some change in education policy that may allow a justified place to Sanskrit, it deserves, and thus allow Indians to know its heritage, the picture would certainly be bright. Sanskrit is living and will continue to live through the grace of holy men of India, and it will never die. Let us quote a verse of Wilson at the conclusion. Nishpishtapi param pada hoti shatahi shashvad bahu praninam santaptapi kiranai shahasra kiranena agnis phulingo pamai chagaddai मृश्चर्वितापि सततम् मृष्टापि कुद्दालपै दुर्वान अम्रियते कृशापि नितराम् धातुर दया दुर्बले ब्राह्मी विजयताम विश्वे देवभाषा सनातनी नमो नमः सर्वे भो नमो नमः
थैंक यू सर फॉर योर प्रेजेंटेशन एंड वेरी इंफॉर्मेटिव लेक्चर सर वी हैड सम क्वेश्चंस ऑन आवर चैट चैनल One student has asked that sir, one student has asked that either the Sanskrit is useful for Indian only or it is useful for it is useful in abroad also. Am I audible, sir? महोदय केचन छात्रैः छात्रेण पृष्टं यद् अस्माकम् ऐतिह्यरक्षणार्थं संस्कृतम् आवश्यकं भारतीयानाम् ऐतिह्यरक्षणार्थं संस्कृतम् आवश्यकं किन्तु विदेशीयाः ये च संस्कृतं पठन्ति तेषामपि ऐतिह्यरक्षणार्थं किं संस्कृतम् आवश्यकम् उत वा ते भारतीय ऐतिह्यरक्षणार्थं संस्कृतं पठन्ति
भारतीय
छात्राणां तत्र प्रश्नः अस्ति
किमस्ति किमं प्रश्नः न श्रुतं मया
पृष्टं केनापि छात्रेण यद् अस्माकं भारतीय ऐतिह्यरक्षणार्थं भारतीयपरम्परारक्षणार्थं वयं संस्कृतं पठामः अस्माकं विद्यालयेषु विश्वविद्यालयेषु महाविद्यालयेषु अन्य मठादिषु तत्र वयं संस्कृतं पठामः ये च विदेशीयाः सन्ति विदेशेषु विराजमानः विश्वविद्यालयेषु ये च संस्कृतविभागाः सन्ति तत्रापि यत्र संस्कृतपठनपाठनं भवति ते अपि किम् अस्माकं देशीयः तत्र परम्परारक्षणार्थं ते संस्कृतपठनपाठनं कुर्वन्ति अथवा अन्यत् किमपि कारणमस्ति
नहि यदि सत्यं वदामि तर्हि एतदेव तर्हि एतत् खलु अवधार्यं यत् न ते भारतीय कल्चर् इति भारतीयसंस्कृति रक्षणाय ते संस्कृतं पठन्ति केवलम् आयुर्वेदज्ञानार्थं योगस्य उपयोगिताज्ञानार्थं भारतीयदर्शनज्ञानार्थम् एवम् वस्तुतस्तु संस्कृतज्ञानाय न संस्कृत अध्ययनं परन्तु गवेषणार्थमेव एतत्तु मम मदीया अभिज्ञता एव वर्तते किमर्थं तत्र बहवः छात्राः पेरिस् नगरे यथा एकः छात्रः आसीत् स तु विचारकः आसीत् पेरिस् नगरस्य विचारकः आसीत् परन्तु इण्डियन् जुरिस्पुडेन्स् भारतीयव्यवस्थायां किमस्ति तद्ज्ञानार्थमेव स संस्कृतस्य छात्रो अभूत् वस्तुतस्तु एतेषां छात्राणां संस्कृतस्य बेसिक नॉलेज इति तन्न भवति तदर्थं किञ्चित् असौविध्यं भवति परन्तु ते एतत् जानन्ति फ्रॉम भारतीयपण्डिताः ये तावत् गच्छन्ति तेभ्यः ते एवं ज्ञातुम् इच्छन्ति यद् भारतीय विचारव्यवस्थायां चतुष्पाद व्यवहारे कीदृशो अस्ति एवमेवं याज्ञवल्क्यसंहिता वा अथवा इदानीमेवम् अस्ति चरकेषु सुते वा किं किम् अस्ति अथवा योगाभ्यासस्य एवं भवति इण्डियन् फिलोसफी दर्शन भारतीयदर्शनं तदपि परन्तु भारतीयसंस्कृतिज्ञानार्थं यदि यदि इतिहासस्य छात्राः भवन्ति तदा तत्ते सोशियोलजि इति विभागस्य ये तावत् छात्राः कथञ्चित् ते भारतीयज्ञानार्थं परन्तु भारतीयसंस्कृतिपोषणार्थं तेषां संस्कृतज्ञानम् इति कथनं न युक्तियुक्तं भविष्यति एतत् मम अभिज्ञता
Sir, one more question from one research scholars from our department only. He has asked about the education policy, new education policy. Anyone who studies Sanskrit can study also physics and many more subjects. What is your opinion regarding this?
My opinion. Long before maybe 20 years back at Rabindra Bharati University, I had made a suggestion, but as you understand that it was not implemented. I said that all Sanskrit students must go to fine arts department, that is dance, drama, etc., etc. And in my university, there was not there is no Sanskrit science faculty at all. But knowing Sanskrit and knowing science is a good idea. But till class 12, if there is no emphasis on science subjects and Sanskrit studies at the same time, then it is hard to be implemented, but I fully support that science students, basically that science subjects and Sanskrit subjects should be studied together, jointly, no problem, and that would be good. That would be good. In ancient days, our good doctors were knowing very, very good Sanskrit. But now the streams are very specialized. So, in the days of specialization, I do not know how far it would be practical. If it is done, it is very well. I welcome it. Is it?
Yes, it's clear. And,
you got it.
I think our scholars and everyone should be very clear. Aapne bahut acche se sir spasht kiya.
Namaskar, dhanyawad.
Thank you for your inspiration and informative lecture. Asmakam tatra bhavadbhiya duktam nirantaram samskrita bhashayam karyam chalati sampurnepi bharate vardhate cha vidyalayanam mahavidyalaye vishwavidyalaye sarvatra chalati prachar prasarartham tatra anyepi tatra math mathadishupi tatra sarvakaryasya vibhinna संस्थासु अपि तत्र कार्यं चलति विदेशे अपि वर्धमानाः सन्ति केचन संस्कृतविभागीयः विभागस्य तत्र नाम परिवर्तनमपि जातं तत् केचन कष्टकरः अस्ति तदापि तत्रत्यः अध्यापकाः निरन्तरं कार्यं कुर्वन्ति संस्कृतविषये तत्र अनुसन्धानं कुर्वन्ति कम्प्यूटर् क्षेत्रे पर्यावरणक्षेत्रे विज्ञानविषये अन्ये च बहवः बहुषु क्षेत्रेषु निरन्तराः प्रयासरताः सन्ति अस्माकं तत्र ऐतिह्यरक्षणार्थं संस्कृतिरक्षणार्थम् अस्माभिः संस्कृतस्य अध्ययनं करणीयमेव संस्कृतस्य भविष्यमपि उज्ज्वलः एव अस्ति केचन तत्र शिक्षानीतौ यदि तादृशपरिवर्तनं कृतमपि इदानीं नवीनशिक्षानीतौ
ओतिसम प्रति केवलम दिवसद्वयात् प्राक् न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी आयात परंतु इदानीमपि स्पष्टतया किञ्चित् ज्ञायते साधु प्रस्ताव साधु
बहु बहु धन्यवादः अस्ति भवतां तत्र व्यस्तकार्यक्रमेषु अपि तत्र इदानीं तु राइट नाउ ऑल द पेंडेमिक इन दिस पेंडेमिक कोविड 19 एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग ऑनलाइन एंड somebody has some persons have some problem with this online things but
कार्यकाले श्रुतं हो कार्यकाले समुत्पन्ने न सा विद्या न तद्धनम् परंतु नेट कनेक्शन इज सो वीक इट कैन नॉट बी कनेक्टेड सो विदाउट यूज ऑनलाइन इज गुड बट अनलेस एंड अंटिल द कनेक्टिविटी इज नॉट गुड इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट यू सी नाउ आई एम टॉकिंग विद द मोबाइल फोन एंड दैट टू बट हेल्प ओनली my laptop is just placed here idle. It is not working because low connectivity. So these things have to be taken care of by the administration. Otherwise, online education. Anyway,
nowadays we have no other option. This is the option, and
no option.
Thank you very much. भवतां बहु बहु हार्दं धन्यवादं व्याहरामि अस्माकं विभागपक्षतः अन्ये च ये च श्रोतारः सन्ति अस्य कार्यक्रमस्य ये च समारोहे संस्कृतसप्ताह समारोहे ये च भागं गृहीतवन्तः तेषां समेषां प्रतिपि हार्दिकम् अभिनन्दनं हार्दिकं स्वागतं हार्दिकं धन्यवादं विज्ञापयामि अस्माकं संस्कृतविभागपक्षतः असम विश्वविद्यालयस्य संस्कृतविभागपक्षतः अस्माकं विभागाध्यक्षं प्रति प्रोफेसर शांति पोखरेल महाभागं प्रति अपि हार्दिक्यं कार्तज्ञं विनिवेदयामि विभागस्य वरिष्ठाचार्यः प्रोफेसर स्निग्धादासराय महाभागः तां प्रति अपि हार्दिक्यं कार्तज्ञं विज्ञापयामि विभागीयः एव आचार्य प्रोफेसर भागीरथी विश्वास महाभागः अपि सन्ति तां प्रति अपि हार्दिक्यं धन्यवादं विज्ञापयामि अन्ये च अस्माकं विश्वविद्यालयस्य कुलपतयः सन्ति तम् अनुज्ञय एव कार्यक्रमोऽयं चलति एवं सफली भविष्यति च तं प्रति अपि हार्दिक्यं धन्यवादं विज्ञापयामि अस्माकं विभागस्य ये च शोधछात्राः ये च छात्राः तेषां समेषां प्रति अपि विभागपक्षतः हार्दिक्यं धन्यवादं निवेदयामि ते अन्यस्मिन् सत्रेपि श्वः तत्र पुनः व्याख्यानं भविष्यति प्रोफेसर नरोत्तम सेनापति महोदयस्य सः विश्वभारती विश्वविद्यालये विद्यन्ते तत्र तेषां व्याख्यानं भविष्यति सर्वे श्वः पुनः सार्धैकादशवादने आयन्तु समेषां प्रति हार्दिक्यं धन्यवादं विज्ञापयामि पुनः श्वः मिलामः समेषां धन्यवादः नमस्कारः
नमस्कार
ये पुनः एक निवेश अस्माकं सकाशत् तत्र समापनगीतम् अस्ति तत्र समापनगीतगायनार्थं तत्र अन्वेषा तमोली अस्ति अन्वेषा अस्ति किम्
अस्ति वा
मन्ये डिस्कनेक्ट अभवत् ओम शान्तिः 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 इत्यनेनैव विरमामः पुनः श्वः मिलामः धन्यवादः
नमस्कारः Thank you.